In today's video, I'll show you how to switch your character's weapons. Yui Chan will demonstrate on this event. This character is already imported into Unity after rigging has been completed. Here are three weapon prefab game objects that will be used as tests. As you can see, the weapon's mesh is set as a child of the game object created by Unity. And keep in mind that the local position is on the weapon's handle. Now, let's create a feature for the character to switch three weapons. Select the character and find the right hand bone. Select the right hand bone, click the right mouse button, and create an empty game object. Name it Pivot Weapon R. Before doing any scripting, you need to make sure that this object is positioned correctly. Move one of the weapons to the child of Pivot Weapon R. The weapon is not in the right position. I will move the Pivot Weapon R until we are satisfied with it. That looks good. I will delete the weapon. Now, let's start working on scripting for weapon switching. I will create a script called Weapon Change and attach it to the character. I don't need the update method in this script, so I'm going to delete it. First, let's create a public transform variable so we can get the Pivot Weapon R. Let's register Pivot Weapon R directly in the variable in the inspector. In addition, the tag of the character is player. Next, create an empty game object and name it Manager Weapon. I will create a script with the same name and attach it to the Manager Weapon game object. Again, I'm not going to use the update method, so I'll delete it. I will create a public array variable to store multiple prefab game objects. Put three weapon prefab game objects into the array variable. Note that the array index starts at 0. Therefore, the index of the third weapon is 2, not 3. Let's create a UI button for the function of changing weapons. We will create an empty game object in Canvas and create three buttons below it. If you use the grid layout component, you can easily control multiple buttons or other UI elements. Write the names of the buttons according to the arrangement of the weapons you made earlier. We will create an empty game object in the scene, and name it Manager UI. Create create a manager UI script and attach it to the object you just created. This script will also not use the update method, so I will delete it. We will use the event system so we can check which button was clicked. As you may have noticed, the event system is automatically created when you add a canvas. Event system provides convenient functions for UI control. I am going to add the event system directive at the top of the script. Create a public method to receive an event when a button is clicked. Next, let's put the code to check which button was clicked. After creating a game object variable that is used only within the method, write the following code. You can check which button was pressed. However, since we are using the array's index number to swap weapons, we need to find out the child index number of the button we clicked on. Set sibling index, one of transform commands, is responsible for getting the order of a specific child by number. Let's also put the debug code so we can check the index number. Apply the button weapon change method to each button's onclick event. As you can see in the console, the name and index number of the clicked button are confirmed. Now, let's create a public method that works when a button is pressed. Can you see an integer variable parameter in the method? Let's go back to the manager UI script and put the code to execute the method. Before that, you need to get the component to execute the method of the manager weapon change class. Since I set the tag of the character object to player, I will use the tag to define the object and then store the component in a variable. After the class variable name, write the method name, create parentheses and put an integer parameter in it. Then the index number of the weapon to be switched is transmitted to the method. Let's create a code for the character to equip that weapon. Let's import the component to use the variable in the manager weapon class. We will first get the game object of the selected weapon from the array in the manager weapon script. Since the weapon doesn't exist in the scene, we'll use the instantiate command to bring the prefab weapon object to the scene. The instantiate command provides friendly options for parenting, as well as the ability to clone and pull game objects into the scene. Simply put the parent's name after the comma. However, the parent object must be a transform variable. Let's check that the weapon object is loaded into the scene. When you press the button, you can see that the weapon appears properly in the character's hand. But the problem is, the weapon keeps popping up every time I press the button. This makes visual problems and overall performance degradation. Let's solve the problem. First of all, we will make the character have a default weapon when running the game. In this case, we will use the stick, the first weapon in the array. When you launch the game, the stick weapon is automatically brought into the character's hand. Since we have already used the stick weapon with index number 0 in the start method first, we will create a separate integer variable and initialize it. Conditions must be created to prevent repeated spawning of weapons. In my case, I will use a method not to execute the code when the same index number is called. Then cut the code below and paste it inside the conditional statement. Add code to store the index of the switched weapon so that it can be reused in conditional statements. Finally, before the instantiate command is executed, the existing weapon should be destroyed. Since there is no variable for the equipped weapon, let's use an indirect variable through the getChild command. Everything seems to be done. Let's run the game. You can see that the switching of the weapon works well. That's all for today's video. Thank you. See you next time.